I think it was far too kind. It's always lovely to be here. I've been here before, and what's really nice to be here is that it's a chance to interact with people that are like-minded, a chance to interact with people that are doing social good, a chance to interact with people that are having a positive impact on society. And it always feels wonderful to be in a place like this. So a big round of applause to the organizers of this. It's early morning, I haven't had my coffee as yet. So I'm here to talk to you about something that I feel really passionately about. Richard Branson, I was reading his interview recently, and he said that this is something that can truly transform the world that we live in. It's called crowdfunding, and it's a platform that I started about 5 years back called Ketto. For those of you who don't know what crowdfunding is, how many of you know what crowdfunding is actually? Okay, quite a few. For those of you that don't know what crowdfunding is, it's really about raising large amounts of money from lots of people, usually for causes that are social, individual, or creative, and it's usually done via the internet using technology. To put it simply, actually, is that so if you had to raise, if you needed money for, say, education, or you needed money to help a relative that was sick, what would usually happen is that if you needed 1 lakh rupees and you didn't have the money, you would reach out to one person and say, can I borrow 1 lakh rupees? Or you'd reach out to two people and say, can I borrow 50,000 rupees each? What crowdfunding allows you to do is to reach out to thousands of people and ask them for small amounts of money, which is 100, 200, 500 rupees, which makes it easier to raise that 1 lakh. And more or more often than not, people give that money out of the goodness of their heart. So it's not like you have to return that money either. So that's what crowdfunding really is. I mean, it might seem like a new concept, but it's something that's been around forever. In fact, the Statue of Liberty was crowdfunded. The French sent the statue, but they forgot to send the base. So the Americans were in a bit of a quandary because they were like, okay, we have the statue, what are we supposed to do with it now? So one of the newspapers decided that they would come up with a crowdfunding campaign. It wasn't called a crowdfunding campaign at that point of time. But they reached out to people and they said, you know, look, we have this lovely statue, but we don't have the base. And it would be wonderful if people could come forward and contribute so that we could put up the statue. So people came forward, 1 cent, 2 cents, 5 cents, 10 cents, $1. And soon enough, they had raised enough money to get the base on which the Statue of Liberty stands today. My first experience with crowdfunding, and I think it's an experience that many of you must have had as well, is started when I was about 14 years old. I lived in this society with, we were about 25 children. And one of the kids that always played with us was the watchman's son. He was part of our gang. And one day I remember he was sitting in a corner and he was refusing to play. So we went up to him and we asked him, you know, what was wrong? And he said that I'm going to have to drop out of school. So for us, you know, taking care of our parents, it was a really sort of strange concept. Why would you want to drop out of school? He said, you know, look, I don't have enough money to pay for the education and the books and the uniform. And my dad has said that, you know, I'm going to have to drop out of school. So we asked him how much money he needed, and he said about 5,000 rupees. So that day, 25 of us went home, and we asked our parents for 100 rupees, 200, 300, 400, 500. And the next day we had 6,000 rupees to pay for his education. So that was my first interaction with crowdfunding, and I'm sure all of us at some point have done something like that. You know, we haven't realized that really it is about crowdfunding, but it is about people coming together to help someone from the goodness of their heart. And that's really what crowdfunding is. The reason that I started Ketto was that 5-6 years back, I was working with a number of NGOs, and I found that there were a lot of problems and challenges that these NGOs faced. Firstly was the challenge of raising money, which is of course difficult. Secondly, the cost of fundraising I thought was very high. I mean, for every 100 rupees that was being raised, 40-50 rupees is actually going into raising that money, which I thought was really unfair. And I felt like that needed to come down so that the money reached the people that actually needed it. And thirdly, I found that in our country, the whole social space had a lot of seriousness and gravity attached to it. So there was a lot of young people that wanted to be involved, but they felt like maybe this is not for me. You know, maybe this is not the right space for me. Maybe this is for people that are slightly more intellectual and serious. Whereas when I looked out west at the whole ecosystem, it was a lot of fun. I mean, there were garage sales, there were celebrities involved, people were baking cakes, and I felt like that was a ecosystem that needed to come into our country as well. A lot of fun so that a lot of young people would be involved. And in the last 5.5-6 years that we've been operational, we've raised over 900 million rupees now for social and individual and creative causes. We've raised money for everything from the Nepal earthquake to the floods that happened in Kashmir, to a dancer that wanted to dance again, to somebody that suffers social causes, individual causes and creative causes. Then there's no reason that we can't raise money for infrastructure projects. There's no reason that we can't raise money for medical research, for technical breakthroughs, for things that the government is not paying attention to or corporates don't have the bandwidth to pay attention to. And there's no reason that we can't crowdfund our way out of a lot of problems that the world finds itself in today. So thank you. Thank you so much for having me here and giving me a chance to talk about something that I'm passionate about. I'd also like to introduce Suresh. Suresh, if you could come up. Suresh happened to be here and I thought it would be wonderful to have him here. We just actually crowdfunded for a prosthetic leg for Suresh. And someone started a campaign, we were able to raise enough money, and Suresh is here today. Suresh, aap kuch kehna chahenge? Please.
Namaste, my name is Suresh. And I'm a 10K khiladi. I've given 10K exam. And my first time in bus is not one. And I didn't have to take any time. और आज कैटो की वजह से और नदी ट्रस्ट की वजह से मैं जा सकता हूँ, दौड़ सकता हूँ, साइकिलिंग करता हूँ, स्विमिंग करता हूँ और मुझे ITI में कंप्यूटर का जॉब करा, मुझे कंप्यूटर सीखना है और अच्छी नौकरी जॉब करनी है. थैंक यू.
Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day and a wonderful
morning. Can I request you to please remain on the stage? I already goofed up by not calling Amit and presenting you the welcome bouquet in my anxiety. So Amit, can we have you on the stage? Before we present a memento and of course a book, of course a gesture of thanksgiving to Kunal. Here's the welcome bouquet.
We all forget sometimes.
So my apologies for that, Kunal, and here it is. We are heartily welcoming you to the day two of the CSR show, and thank you for being a speaker with us today. Thank you so much. We'd also like to extend a token of appreciation in the form of the CSR Good Book, the 7th edition. So there we go. And we'd also like to invite Sahil from Fuel to please come forward and present a memento, of course, to Kunal. Sahil, can we have you on the stage very quickly? Okay, so anybody from Phil? Alright, so we'll ensure that we, of course, get the memento, of course, given to Kunal. Well, any questions from the audience? Quick one. Or any compliments, rather, from your end? No issues, he'll have the pleasure of getting it from you, so. There we go. Thank you so much, Kunal. Thanks a lot. We wish Ketto all the best. Thanks a lot.